everyone, it's your girl Layla. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to the last episode of Spooktober for 2021. I am so sad this series is ending again for this year because I really enjoy making these videos. I really enjoy visiting these spooky locations for you guys and filming it and then researching it. I just love the whole process of Spooktober. And I can't believe how fast it's gone by this year. Spooktober wouldn't really be complete if I didn't visit a ghost town. And this year, I saved it for the very end and visited Lille ghost town in the Crowsnest Pass for you guys. So if you guys are not already subscribed, please go ahead, click the subscribe button below. I upload 3 times a week, Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday. So let's get started on Lille ghost town. I discovered this ghost town actually in a weird way. So I was browsing all trails a while ago, I want to say. I think it was last year. Saved it to one of my hiking lists. I think I just saved it to my favorites list and forgot about it. Then one of my friends mentioned that she wanted to do this hike and I was like, wait a second, I could use that footage for Spooktober. I was like, wait a minute, that's on my save list too. Hikes are obviously my favorite thing. I love to get out there. I love to adventure. But this trail takes you to a ghost town. How crazy is that? I think that this is just a really, really amazing fall hike. A hike for this time of year, for spooky season. You can do it with your kids. It's not that difficult. You can do this with your friends as well. It was definitely an adventure and I highly recommend it. So let's go ahead and get into the history of Lille. So Lille is located near the town of Frank. And the town of Frank may sound familiar to you, it may not sound familiar to you, but it was actually a Spooktober video that I created from last year on the Frank slide. And basically it was the biggest rock slide in Alberta. And Lille is not very far away from Frank in the Crowsnest Pass. Lille was a coal mining town in operation from 1901 to 1912. Lille was actually founded in 1901 by a French mining company. It was known as the French Camp. If you're wondering about the name Lille and where it actually came from, it's actually a town in France that this town was named after. Two representatives from this coal mining company were surveying the land around the Crowsnest Pass and they discovered a coal seam nearby on Mist Mountain. So they decided to create a little town here. And this town reached a population of 400 residents at its prime. It included 80 buildings at the time, including miners' residences, a school, a hospital with 15 beds, a liquor store, a bakery. It also included a coal washery with 50 Bernard-style coke ovens. There was also three, I'm gonna butcher this word because I don't know how to say it, but if you guys know how to say it, please correct me. There were three bituminous coal mines. Hopefully I'm saying that word right. In the town, and the coal was produced from the Mist Mountain coal seam. All that's left today are ruins. In its existence, this mine produced 901,000 metric tons of coal. The Grassy Mountain rail line was built between the town of Lille and the town of Frank, which when it got to Frank, it would be put on a Canadian Pacific train and then the coal would be distributed all around Canada. This rail spur was actually very, very expensive to build. They had to build 23 trestle bridges and this land was not the easiest land to navigate on to build a railway. It was very rough, it was very steep. The Valley of Gold Creek was actually also very, very narrow. So it was very hard to navigate a train around there, but they eventually built one. But then the Frank slide happened in 1903, which destroyed a part of the railway as well as a few trestle bridges, and the coal production in Lille halted until Frank was able to be repaired. There was also a lot of destruction in this area, including a forest fire that destroyed trestles. And they had issues in the winter time as well, clearing snow off of the railway because apparently it snows a lot in this region. It's located in a valley, so of course they're gonna get tons of snow. The mines in Lille closed down in 1912 due to weak coal prices as well as poor quality coal. This means that the coal produced in Lille had a really high ash content. The town itself was actually dismantled and the buildings were taken elsewhere, including to little towns nearby. like Blairmore. A set of Bernard-style coke ovens is still at the site today, and that is one of the main attractions to the town of Lille. It's this wonderful set of ruins now, but it was basically a coke oven that was made out of bricks that were imported from Belgium. And if you guys are wondering what a coke oven is, I didn't know what a coke oven was, so I had to Google it. Basically distills the coal, I think is the best way for me to describe that. It basically heats up the coal and then takes out all the water content. And what was left was basically purified coal that they used for fuel back then. Today, you can get to the town of Lille by hiking approximately 6.5 kilometers from the Frank Slide Interpretive Center, or you can take the ATV trail, which was what we did. So you can take an ATV trail up this back road and you can park anywhere along there and then you can hike in. So it made our hike in about 4 kilometers around there. So the remains that were left in the town of Lille include, of course, those Bernard style coke ovens that I was mentioning earlier, as well as some foundations from other buildings. There is the hotel foundation still there. There's also the powerhouse and coal washery, which is just a brick foundation that is really close to the coke ovens. There's also piles of coal slack around here, and apparently you can get to the three mines. We were looking for them on our hike because the trail is actually pretty hard to follow because there's just one main trail that leads you to a dead end. There's nothing there, but there's also a bunch of side trails that take you to a bunch of different places. So apparently you can see the mine sites of three different mines there. We didn't actually find those, but all that's left are ruins. You can't, you know, go into a mine with a headlamp, which was kind of my thoughts when I discovered this hike on all trails. I was like, oh, that's so cool. You can probably go underground and look at the mines and stuff. No, they were probably filled in over 100 years ago and you can't access them anymore. You can't, you know, take your headlamp into a tunnel or anything. There's just ruins that are left. So also about a 15-minute walk from the town site, which is where most of the ruins are located right now, there is a cemetery. There's a cemetery in the forest. There's actually 12 people buried in the cemetery, but there's only one tombstone that remains. So that is pretty much it for my video on Lille Ghost Town. So before I cut to the footage that I took while I was in Lille Ghost Town, I just want to say I really did enjoy this hike. It was, I would say, easy. I would say that this is a good family fall hike. If you want to take your kids here and, you know, give them a little bit of a history lesson of this area, I would definitely suggest this hike. It's definitely kid friendly and the ruins that are left over are actually really cool. I did kind of venture into the coke oven a little bit to get some photos, but it's like really narrow. You can definitely walk inside though. A little almost tunnel like narrow divisions in the coke oven. You can go in there and kind of take some photos, but definitely be respectful of where you are because this is just a really old, fragile area, so be careful when you're venturing here. But other than that, I had a really cool experience here. It's always really, really fun to visit a ghost town, and when you can hike to a ghost town, those are like two of my favorite things put together. So this trail was really, really awesome. So let's cut into the footage right now and the tour and all of that, and I will see you guys soon in my next video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button below. I upload 3 times a week, Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday, and I will see you guys soon. Bye. Hey guys, so today we're at the little ghost town in the Crowsnest Pass. We just got to this point by an ATV trail. So in this place, there is actually a town site, a couple mines, actually 3 mines, and a cemetery. So that's what we're going to be exploring today. I'll see you guys in the next clip. We just made it to the town site for a little ghost town. I think we're actually at the mining portion. I'm not sure if this is the main town site, but I have this lovely structure behind me that looks really, really cool. I kind of want to go inside actually and explore it. So I'll see you guys in the next clip. So I'm in one of these tunnels. They're so narrow and you can see kind of the end behind me. But they're actually really cool and you can kind of see up as well. That's so, it's actually cool and creepy at the same time.
Thank you.